Hi students, today we will see about the heart disease in pregnancy. Cardiovascular physiology of pregnancy. Increase in cardiac output is the most significant change during pregnancy. It begins to rise in the first trimester and steadily rises to the peak at 32 weeks by 30 to 50%. The cardiac output is normally 4.4 liter per minute. Is 6.5 liter per minute at 8 to 10 weeks of pregnancy and remains so till near term. Increase in cardiac output is achieved by rise in stroke volume in early pregnancy and heart rate in later part of pregnancy adjusting together. Changes in the cardiovascular system during pregnancy include maternal adjustment to pregnancy involves extensive changes in the cardiovascular system. The heart, the size may increase. That is to compensate with increase in the workload. Cardiac output start to increase from the 5th week and reaches maximum by 30 to 34 weeks and return to pre-labor values by 1 hour following delivery and to the pre-pregnant level by another 4 weeks. The blood pressure, systemic vascular resistance decreases due to the smooth muscle relaxation because of the effect of the stroke, so there is no change in the blood pressure during pregnancy. Supine hypertension syndrome. In late pregnancy, the gravid uterus will compress the inferior vena cava in supine position, which will lead to venous return decreases, so in turn decreases the cardiac output that leads to hypertension, tachycardia and syncope. The cardiac output is lowest in sitting or supine position, highest in lateral or niche's position. Cardiac output increases due to the increase in blood volume to meet additional oxygen demand. Increase in cardiac output which leads to increase in stroke volume and heart rate to 15 beats per minute. Normal heart will able to compensate with all these changes. Uterine blood flow is increased from 50 ml per minute to 750 ml per minute at term. Blood flow to the skin and mucous membrane reaches maximum 500 ml per minute by 36th week. The heat sensitization, sweating or stuffy nose usually accompany due to increase of the blood flow to these organs. Two major categories of heart disease are rheumatic heart disease and congenital heart disease. Early diagnosis of underlying heart disease is essential. Signs and symptoms include cyanosis, clubbing, diastolic, pre-systolic or continuous heart murmur, cardiac enlargement, a loud harsh systolic murmur associated with a thrill and serious dysarrhythmias. New York Heart Association functional classification of heart disease include class 1, no functional limitation of activity, no symptoms of cardiac decompensation with activity. Class 2, mild amount of functional limitation. Patients are asymptomatic at rest, ordinary physical activity result in symptoms. Class 3, limitation of most physical activity, asymptomatic at rest, minimal physical activity result in symptoms. Class 4, severe limitation of physical activity result in symptoms, patients may be symptomatic at rest, heart failure at any point of pregnancy. Class 5, if patient is on inotropic support, ventilator, assisted circulation or having compromised renal or pulmonary function necessitating dialysis or ECMO to maintain the vital signs. Prognosis depend upon the functional status. In general, in women in New York Heart Association class 1 and 2, lesions usually do well during pregnancy and have a favorable prognosis with mortality rate of less than 1%. Patients with class 3 and 4 may have mortality rate 5 to 15%. These patients should be advised against becoming pregnant. Criteria to diagnose the cardiac disease during pregnancy include, first is presence of diastolic murmurs, second, systolic murmurs of severe intensity, and unequivocal enlargement of the heart, presence of severe arrhythmias, atrial fibrillation or flutter. The precise diagnosis is not always easy. The symptoms of shortness of breath, palpitation and edema of the feet are common both to normal pregnant women and one with cardiac problem. An enlarged heart, cardiac thrill, diastolic murmur and fibrillation are characteristic findings of cardiac disease. Investigations include chest X-ray, shows an enlarged heart, congestion in the upper pulmonary zone, ECG, Doppler USG will show the blood and circulation changes, echo will diagnose the cardiac abnormality. The indications for termination of pregnancy include because of high maternal risk, MDP is indicated in case of Essenmenger syndrome, Marfan syndrome with aortic involvement, pulmonary hypertension, coarctation of aorta with valvular involvement. Termination should be done before 12 weeks of pregnancy. Risk factors for cardiac failure during pregnancy include infection, anemia, obesity, hypertension, hyperthyroidism, multiple pregnancy, advanced age, cardiac arrhythmias, history of previous heart failure, risk factors like infection and anemia, inadequate supervision. Management during pregnancy is an important aspect of management or the cardiac patient planning surgery. Ideally, obstetrician and cardiologist should work together to help the patient make an informed decision. Prevent unwanted pregnancy and avoid the risk of associated with pregnancy in continuation or termination. The cases with grade 3 and 4 atrial fibrillation and Essenmenger syndrome should strongly advise against pregnancy. Buttonhole mitral stenosis should be surgically corrected before pregnancy is attempted. The chief aim of management of patients in pregnancy is to keep patient within her cardiac reserve. If the patient is opt for MDP, it can be done. It is preferable to have detailed baseline information prior of pregnancy. Cases with 3 and 4 fibrillating heart should be hospitalized all throughout the pregnancy. Rest, infection to be avoided, prophylactic antibiotics 3 to 4 weekly administered in case of valvular lesions should not exceed normal weight gain during pregnancy. Anemia should be treated with prophylactic iron tablet. BP should be checked regularly. Antepartum care include limiting activities helpful in severely affected women with ventricular dysfunction, left heart obstruction or class 3 and 4 symptoms. Hospital admission by mid-second trimester may be advisable for some. Problems should be identified early and treated aggressively, especially pregnancy-induced hypertension, hyperthyroidism, infection, and anemia. Oral therapy with warfarin is effective and logistically easy. Fetal intracranial bleeding is a risk throughout pregnancy, particularly during vaginal delivery, unless warfarin is stopped before labor. However, it can affect the embryonic organ development, although some evidence show that dosage of 5 mg per day may not be teratogenic. Heparin is adjusted subcutaneous doses, does not cross the placenta and has no teratogenic effect. However, it may cause maternal thrombocytopenia and osteoporosis and is less effective in preventing thrombosis in patients with prosthetic valve. Warfarin used in the first trimester can be teratogenic and it may lead to nasal cartilage hypoplasia, stripling of bones, IUGR and brachydactyly. Physiological changes during labor and viparium in the first stage, cardiac output increase by 15%, uterine contraction increases the venous return causing increase in cardiac output and can cause reflex bradycardia. Second stage, increase in intra-abdominal pressure by Valsalva manoeuvre causes decrease in venous return and cardiac output. Third stage, normal blood loss during delivery is around 250 to 350 ml. It may lead to decreased blood volume and decreased cardiac output. Every effort is made to minimize the effect of labor on cardiovascular system. The woman should be placed on her side with a head and shoulder elevator, oxygen administered to increase the oxygen saturation. Environment should be kept quiet and calm as possible to decrease anxiety, which can cause tachycardia. Fetus monitor electronically and signs of fetal compromise as well as maternal signs of cardiac decompensation should be detected. Sedation, epidural analgesia are helpful. Prophylactic antibiotics should be started. Vaginal delivery is recommended for a woman with heart disease unless there is a specific indication for cesarean. Cesarean section is indicated in case of aortic dissection, Marfan syndrome with dilated aortic root, taking warfarin within 2 weeks of labor. Preterm induction is uncommon. However, once fetal lung maturity is assured, A planned induction and delivery may be warranted for high-risk patients to ensure that appropriate staff and equipment are available. Positioning the patient on her left side lessens the hemodynamic fluctuations associated with the contractions when the patient is on supine. Forceps or vacuum extraction should be considered at the end of second stage of labor to shorten and ease the delivery and to avoid excessive bearing down effort. Methergine should not be administered because it causes hypertension and increased venous return. Some amount of blood loss during delivery is beneficial in case of cardiac disease complicating pregnancy. Oxytocin is a safe and first stage associated with special risk after delivery of the placenta, about 500 ml of blood is returned to intravascular volume. To minimize the overloading heart, abrupt position change should be avoided. Uterus should not be massaged to expedite separation of the placenta. Careful assessment for signs of circulatory overload, just bounding pulse, distended neck and peripheral veins, and moist rails in the lungs. Postpartum monitoring include, because of hemodynamics does not return to baseline for many days after delivery, patients at intermediate or high risk may require monitoring for at least 72 hours postpartum. Observe closely for signs of infection, thromboembolism, and hemorrhage. These conditions act together to precipitate postpartum heart failure. Continue to observe for congestive cardiac failure. Observe urine output because inadequate urine output reflects the heart inability to circulate blood adequately to the kidneys. Lactation should be encouraged unless patient is in failure. Cardiac output is not compromised during lactation. Lactation is the pathway for fluid excretion and diuretic requirement may actually fall. Signs and symptoms of cardiac failure include cough that is frequent, productive with hemoptysis, progressive dyspnea, orthopnea, pitting edema of the legs and feet for generalized edema of the face, hands or sacral edema, heart palpitation, progressive fatigue or syncope with exertion, moist rails in lower lobes indicating pulmonary edema. Barrier method is unreliable, progesterone only pill have better side effect profile and long-acting, slow-releasing as Mirena intrauterine system have improved efficiency. Sterilization where family is completed. Thank you. Thank you for listening.